Academy. My name is Ashish Garg, and today we are going to study about the shear stresses of the beams, and we are going to see mainly previous year questions from this topic that is being asked in the engineering service examination and the GATE examination. I will be telling you the concepts from which the mainly questions is being asked. So let's start our today's topic with shear stress of beam. That is shear stress of beam. Now, if you see the question asked from this particular portion, from is mainly shear stresses. How to calculate the shear stresses in beam? Now we know that shear stress formula is given as VA y bar by I times into width of the section. Question asked to you is, you have given a simply supported beam. The kind of question is being asked. If this is our first type, you have given a simply supported beam subjected to a load W, and you have also given a maximum shear stress, say 5 MPa. Let's say 5 MPa, and this length is given to you. This length is also given to you. Now you have to find the value of W. And you have given a cross section, that is rectangular cross section of say depth 500 or say 500 or width 300. Now you have to find the value of W. This is first kind of question that is being asked in the exam. Now from here, again the second type of question, if we correlate, it will be related to your shear stress distribution. Shear stress distribution. How the what is the maximum value of shear stress if we compare it with the average stress in case of rectangular section? For example, you have been asked to calculate the tau maximum rectangular time is equals to tau times of average rectangular, or you may have been asked tau maximum in circle is equals to tau average in circle, or you have been asked to tau maximum in case of triangle in tau average in case of triangle, or you may have been asked tau maximum in case of diamond section is equals to tau average in case of diamond section. So these are the kind of question that is being asked from this part. This is our second variety. Now from this formula, the third type is, you have been asked to calculate the shear stress value, and you have to calculate the shear stress value, and you have given a shear force, and you have given moment of inertia and the width of the section. Based on that, you have third variety of questions. You have simply also been asked your shear stress value for a given section does not depend upon, for a given section does not depend upon, does not depend upon. Your options are, this is the your previous year question of IAS exam. Your option are shear, your options are shear, area, and third one is moment of inertia. You have to tell in which cases shear stresses does not depend upon this parameter. So do it yourself. That is our third kind of question. Now fourth kind of question is, you have given this rectangular section having subjected to a shear force V, and you have been asked to calculate how much shear force is being resisted by upper third section, that is this distance d by 3. How much shear force is resisted by upper third section पर थर्ड सेक्शन. दिस इज अवर फोर्थ काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन दैट इज बीइंग आस्क्ड फ्रॉम द शियर स्ट्रेसेस इन बीम. व्हाई आई एम टेलिंग यू दिस, बिकॉज इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड द क्वेश्चंस एंड नाउ यू आर रीडिंग द कॉन्सेप्ट्स, यू विल बी इजिली एबल टू विजुअलाइज व्हाट आर द आंसर यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट व्हेन यू रीड एनी कॉन्सेप्ट. दैट इज द मेन पर्पज हेयर टू टेल टू समराइज ऑल दीज क्वेश्चंस. सो योर ऑप्शन मे बी 0, इट मे बी वी बाई 3, इट मे बी 8V/90 और 7V/90 और 28, 7V/28 या से 29 और नन ऑफ अबोव. सो डू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन और व्हेन यू रीड योर कंसेप्ट ट्राई टू विजुलाइज द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन. फिफ्थ काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन दैट इज बीइंग आस्क्ड फ्रॉम हेयर इज यू हैव गिवन अ रेक्टेंगुलर सेक्शन एंड यू हैव गिवन अ सर्कुलर सेक्शन. यू हैव टू टेल विच ऑफ दिस सेक्शन हैज मोर शेयर स्ट्रेस रेजिस्टेंस, विच हैज मोर शेयर फोर्स रेजिस्टेंस. लिखो, राइट डाउन शेयर फोर्स रेजिस्टेंस, विच इज हैज मोर शेयर फोर्स रेजिस्टेंस. दीज काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन आर ऑल्सो आस्ड इन द एग्जाम. सो दिस इज अवर फोर्थ वेराइटी. नाउ इफ यू सी अदर वेराइटी फ्रॉम दिस पार्ट हेयर, यू हैव क्वेश्चन रिलेटेड टू द शेयर सेंटर और यू हैव क्वेश्चन मेनली फ्रॉम द शेयर सेंटर ऑफ द बीम्स. यू विल फाइंड आउट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द शेयर सेंटर ऑफ द बीम और यू हैव गिवन अ पर्टिकुलर सेक्शन. You have to ask to find out the shear stress in that section. For example, our sixth variety here. Now you have given this section. You have given this cross section. You have to tell the shear force diagram corresponding to this section. You have to tell the shear force diagram corresponding to this section. So this is another kind of question. That is our sixth question. This shape may vary. For example, the shape may be something like this. It may be a T section. It may be a T section also, or inverted T section. Any type of questions is being asked to calculate you the draw the shear stress diagram. So this is our sixth variety. Now moving to our seventh variety that is asked in the exam. Is mainly from the shear center, that is from the shear center of the beam. In seventh, if I say here, this is our seventh, you have to tell the shear center of the beam. If this is a channel section, if this is your channel section of width B, this is also width of flange, this is given to you as H. This is again width of web. You have to tell at which point, if this is our E, that is eccentricity, and if here a load is acting in this direction, this is a beam given to us. This is being given to us and their dimensions are given to us. You have to tell at which distance the load should be applied so that we have no twisting and no bending in case of this particular beam. That is, we want to locate its shear center. If this W load is acting here, find location of shear center. You have been asked to find the location of shear center. Shear center. What is shear center? It is the point of zero twisting or pure bending. It is that transverse load that should be applied in order to obtain zero twisting and pure bending moment. That is the definition of shear center. So you have to tell the location of shear center in this case, and shear center is the property of shear center is the property of section. It is the property of section, not loading. So keep that in mind. It is the property of section. For this particular, I will tell you formula here. For this particular section, I will tell you formula. It is b square h square t divided by 4i, where t is given as this section, and width of the section is given to you is this section. This is your width, this is your h value, this is your h value, t is given to you, and moment of inertia is given to you. Based on this value, you can calculate your E value. So this is another question related to shear center. In similar here, eighth question is, if you have a thin semicircle having center at this point and radius r subjected to angle 90 degree at this point. Now again you have to tell a distance, if this is a distance at which certain load is applied, to find the value of E such that we have no twisting in the section. So you have to find the value of E. Again you have to calculate the shear center. So here also we have certain formula to calculate the E value, that is equals to 2 times of R beta sine beta minus beta cos beta, sine beta minus beta cos beta, divided by beta minus sine beta cos beta, beta minus sine beta cos beta. This is the formula here. This is the formula that is directly asked from here. Now another question that is being asked from this particular formula. These all are related to the shear stress in beams. I want you to understand these are the questions asked in the IAS exam and GATE exam, so that when you read your concept, you prepare for these questions. That's why the main reason here is to make you acquaint how to solve these questions after reading particular concept. Ninth question is related to, if you have given this section, say this is your section, or another section, say this is another section, you have been asked to calculate the shear center of this particular section. You have to find out shear center of this section. So these are the questions usually being asked from the shear stresses in beams. So I hope you understand what I trying to convey here. I want you to read all these questions, and when you read the particular concept, you will be able to answer all these questions. So thank you for watching this video.